What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Durbin Compound. If you haven't met me already, my name is Devin Durbin. So today on the channel, we are doing a best beginner's tool bag or a best bag for the apartment condo, or maybe even it's just your first toolkit moving into your own house. So I'm gonna break it down. You stay tuned. Alright, so first things first, I want to make this disclaimer for any pros or advanced do-it-yourselfers out there. Keep in mind that this is a very beginner bag. So this is the first set of tools that you ever have. Maybe you don't even know anything about tools. Something along those lines where you're moving into your first apartment, you move out at 18, and you're trying to figure out what should I buy, what should I put in my toolkit for an extreme beginner. Keep in mind, you're not going to be working on a lot of stuff because it may be a leased place. You might be paying rent. You might have a landlord. You're not working on your own stuff. So keep that in mind when I'm going through this bag. So first and foremost, a nylon bag is a great thing to have, a nice heavy-duty stitched bag. I'll roll in a picture of a couple options here. You do not have to go crazy on this. Absolutely every tool that you buy, there is a mild to wild side of the spectrum. So you can go cheap or you can get the nicer stuff if you can afford it. It depends on your budget, it depends on your taste. If you want something that lasts a lifetime, then obviously you're more on the high end or, you know, the higher end of these tools. So let's break it down real quick. Nice nylon bag is important. I think I might start a list here and go. We'll figure out how much money we're spending. We'll add it up as we go. So I'm gonna pick a middle of the road selection. So I'm not gonna pick the cheapest tool that you can buy or the most expensive, but I'm gonna stay middle of the road on my variant of tools. So first things first, I definitely highly recommend a Sharpie. Okay, so these are Sharpie Pros. I really like these Sharpie Pros. They don't roll, they're not round. They're gonna be a little pricey, but they're not the high end. You can get these at pretty much Lowe's, Home Depot. They don't break the bank. Sharpie's a Sharpie. You're using it to mark stuff. You're using it, whatever it might be. Maybe you're hanging a picture and you need to make a mark on the wall. It could be a vast array of things that you would need a Sharpie for, but I think it's definitely the most important thing in your tool bag, because otherwise all the other stuff that you're doing won't make sense if you can't make the mark on the wall or during your project. So that starts my bag off. Next thing are the Vise scissors. So these are shop scissors. These are the 10-inch model. These things are awesome. These things are great for cutting cardboard. Literally anything that you usually cut with scissors, these are awesome for. Just don't cut steel with them. So, you know, if you're unpackaging new furniture, you need to use it as a blade, you can use it as a blade. Maybe you can use them in your kitchen. You can use them, you know, around the bathroom for certain things and just cutting various things. I think a pair of scissors is definitely, you know, something that you should have in your tool bag that are nice. Next up is a utility knife. So I have what's called a carpet knife. A carpet knife is extremely dangerous for a lot of people because it is edged on both sides. A good variant would be the Stanley Fat Max or something like that, where you have an extendable knife blade on the front. So a utility knife is good for scoring things, cutting things. Maybe you need to replace the cord on your lamp. Hey, this is great for cutting back that sheathing on your lamp, get all that insulation out of the way. You use a utility blade. Also good for cutting out caulk or stuff like that, picking at things. A good utility knife will serve you well and last a lifetime. So the next thing up is a small torpedo level. So a torpedo level doesn't break the bank. These are very, very cheap options, and you can get some very good ones. I highly recommend one with at least three bubbles on it. This will get you that 45 degree angle, the 90 degree angle, and 0 degree. So one with a magnet also is very useful to use anywhere. Maybe you're hanging a picture, maybe you just want everything to look squared away and level. a this is the ticket. Maybe you need to readjust a cabinet door. Boom, your level on top. Whatever it might be, you can use a level. That's definitely something that you should have in your arsenal. You do not need anything bigger than this in an apartment. That is my opinion, but I don't think you need a 2 foot or a 4 foot level for that matter. This will do you well. Very cheap option. Next up is a pair of diagonal cutters. So a pair of diagonal cutters is great for just about anything that you want to do. You know, you're cutting cords, maybe you're zip tying something, maybe some computer cables, you have a zip tie. These are great for cutting off those cable ties. Great for snipping wires. Maybe you even have a craft project where you're using safety wire, hanging Christmas lights. You know, anywhere you use metal wire, diagonal cutters come in handy. So you can use it for a vast array of things. I like that you have multiple options. I even strip wires back with this. You don't need a fancy wire stripper. You can do it if you are good enough. Okay, next up is a pair of channel locks. So channel locks are mild to wild. You can get the cheap variant or you can go ahead and get a very expensive variant, but nonetheless, these are very, very handy in a bunch of different situations. With these all the way open, you can undo a trap underneath your sink. Let's say your sink has plugged up and you don't want to call the man, and you can simply take off your trap underneath your sink and fish out whatever you need. These are very capable of doing that, all the way up to any small plumbing issues, replacing a supply line, or just overall holding a nut. These are awesome to have. Channel locks are definitely something that you would want. I forgot to put it in my tool bag, I think. I don't have a adjustable wrench. So an adjustable wrench is something that I would definitely recommend. You do not need a 10-inch variant, maybe an 8-inch or a 6-inch variant of an adjustable wrench. Great for holding bolts. It's multi-adjustable so that you can do a lot of different things with this tool. So adjustable wrench is definitely one that I would put on the list. They're not expensive, they're not gonna break the bank, and they're extremely useful in their own way. Next up is a pair of vise grips. So one size kind of fits all on vise grips, unless you're working on huge things or small things. This thing is pretty good. One size fits all across a huge spectrum. So this is if you have something that, you know, is rounded off and you can't get an actual adjustable or channel locks on it. This is something good for rusted screws, anything and everything that, you know, you might need to grip and keep gripped. This is a very good tool to use. These things come in handy and I would definitely have them in my tool bag. All right, next up. All right, let's get into, all right, you always need a hammer, all right? Whether you're hammering in wall anchors or you're hammering in nails, maybe you're hanging some lights, a hammer is always useful. And maybe a hammer is even useful when you're using stuff like the adjustable wrench for a little bit more power for breaking something loose. So a hammer is always in there. I have a cheap option in my tool bag. You don't really need anything nice. A good S-wing would be sweet. This is a Stanley fiberglass. This is gonna cost you $4 or $5. Really doesn't break the bank. Next up, a tape measure. So I have a magnetic 25 foot from Milwaukee. This is considered probably higher towards the top of the line with tape measures. Tape measures come in all different shapes and sizes. You can get a cheap one. Literally, you know, you use it for hanging pictures, finding the middle of a wall. Maybe you want to hang a TV mount. This is all stuff that you can do with this kit right here. Tape measure. A cheap variant that I have. Look at this, a sleigh maker. I didn't even know that was a company, but I have a cheap tape measure here for beating it around and getting it dirty and things like that. All right, next up, I think that a circuit tester is 100% something that's needed for somebody starting out. That circuit tester is awesome. You literally plug it into your circuit and it will show you if the circuit's okay. If you're in your apartment and something pops a circuit breaker, you might not know exactly what you're doing. You can check it out and make sure that it is the circuit breaker that did pop and it's not something that you know, is part of your appliance. Maybe it's a computer, you've put a power strip on, now you've daisy chained like 10 things together, and then you decide you're gonna put a small space heater underneath your desk, and boom, there goes the circuit. Well, test the circuit by inserting this into your wall outlet, and it will tell you if it's good or not, and then you can trace it back to your circuit breaker panel and reset the circuit breaker. I think this is awesome. This is also good for some bigger bathrooms where you have what's called a ground fault circuit interrupter. So GFCIs pop from time to time. You're using a hairdryer, curling iron, whatever it might be in the bathroom, and you pop that circuit. This might be able to help you figure out what circuit or which GFCI is popped and get it reset for you. Great thing to have. All right, so next up is a drill. So your drill doesn't need to be anything fancy. I have an M18 variant by Milwaukee. This is the cheapest drill I have. This comes in around, I think you can get this kit for around $99. There are a lot of awesome tool kits out there. Ryobi makes a drill and impact combo, I think, that will work out great for you. I'll provide the link here. All these links will be in the description below, so I hope this helps someone out, and I hope I do this video for a just cause. But I recommend a drill only if you are just starting out. A drill only will pretty much do anything and everything that you need. Yes, it will be a little inconvenient to swap in between bits and drill bits and stuff like that, but nonetheless, it will do just about anything you need it to, and it will keep you going in, you know, the face of adversity. And you know, it'll get the job done, whether you're drilling holes, drilling screws, maybe you even come upon a broken screw head, you can chuck the drill down on it and it'll allow you to remove that. Comes that a cheap drill bit set is definitely needed. Now you can get a small drill bit set, or you can get a bigger drill bit set like this where it comes with a bunch of bits. But you know, you can get kits like this from Milwaukee. This is a Shockwave kit. What this has is it has 6 drill bits in it of various sizes. Pretty much get the job done whether you're working on a cabinet, maybe you want to replace a handle or something like that. Maybe you need to drill a hole for a wall anchor. This will get the job done. And then it has pretty much every single bit driver that you would use. Sometimes you get some furniture that comes in and it has really wonky bits. You're probably covered with a bit set like this. So this is something that will definitely come in use in the future. And these kits aren't very expensive. Neither are drill bits. So yeah, that's what I recommend on that. So the last thing in my kit for the beginners is a small ratchet set. So this small ratchet set is obviously missing a ratchet, socket. This socket is a 9/16, so I don't know what's going on with this, but a small socket set will get you by for a lot of things. I would highly recommend that you get metric. A lot of stuff is going to metric these days. Get a metric set, and I think this will definitely carry out all of the duties that you need to do. Maybe you tighten a balcony post with a lag bolt. Maybe it's you know, using it in various things around the apartment or condo. A small socket set like this will get you by and doing a lot of things. Now you can replace it with this, but this is tends to round off a lot of fasteners. In a pinch, you can do anything with an adjustable wrench. Heck, you could probably even do wiring with an adjustable wrench if you're good enough, but you're probably not. Get a small socket set like this. Doesn't cost you a lot of money, and it will cover you for some of those more technical repairs. All right, so one thing I haven't talked about yet is a screwdriver option. So I highly recommend these ratcheting screwdrivers by Milwaukee. The reason I like these so much is that, you know, with this thing, I think this is a 9-in-1 or something like that, a 9-in-1 screwdriver. So you have all of your bits stored in the handle, and you can literally chuck them up. You have forward, reverse. You can get a lot done with this tool. You don't need anything fancy. You can go ahead and get yourself an entire screwdriver kit. That's completely up to you. But that complete screwdriver kit, you know, will just have a bunch of screwdrivers where you can have one. So I highly recommend getting you a multi-bit screwdriver and getting it done like that. All right. Next up is the Stud Buddy. I've done a review on this Stud Buddy. This thing cost you about $9. This Stud Buddy is basically a small two magnets that are encased in plastic. And if you haven't seen the review on it already, I'll link it up here. But for finding studs, maybe you want to mount a picture frame, maybe you want to mount a TV. Great for finding studs. Awesome tool. Requires no electronics. Requires no batteries. And it's made in the U.S. All right, last thing in the tool bag today are my three pry bar set. So I just did a recent review on these Dasco pry bars. These things are awesome. They're used for all kinds of stuff. Whether you need to pry something apart, maybe it's even shipping stuff that has come and you know it comes in a box and you need to pop it open. Hey, you've got a pry bar set for that. Maybe you need to peel back some baseboard that got wet or something. Anything and everything that you can do in an apartment can be done with these. So, you know, prying and doing all kinds of things with that, awesome option here, get you by and a lot of things. So, I hope you guys like that basic beginner's toolkit. I think that is definitely a great start for anybody that's looking into their first set. So, I have some honorable mentions. So, a lot of the times, when I was doing this kit, I thought about putting a lot more things in here, but we're trying to make it as simple as possible. Everything else that I would recommend with this beginner kit is what I would consider a consumable. So things like a small can of WD-40 gets rid of a squeaky hinge in a hot second. Lubricate just about anything and everything, WD-40, honorable mention, a consumable. The next thing is some electrical tape. So whether you're taping up a cord, you need to, you know, tape something together. Electrical tape will usually work on anything other than cardboard. Duct tape is really nasty and you're not gonna tape up some cords with it. Maybe you even have a bundle of cords that you wanna make look good. This electrical tape will come in handy. So some consumable items like that are some honorable mentions in this toolkit. Another thing is drywall anchors. I don't have any drywall anchors right here, but a drywall anchor set will not set you back a lot of money. You can hang a lot of things with drywall anchors. There are many, many variants out there, and they get the job done. So those are some of those consumable items that I wouldn't consider putting in your toolkit because they're just stuff that you use up and that you will have to replace. So you can shove them in your tool bag, but they're not always going to be there. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope it helped someone out there. If you have any good honorable mentions, put them down in the comments below. Let's talk about it. Now, I know a lot of people say, oh, you need this and you need that and you need to put in something else. Why didn't you say this? Okay, that might come in my intermediate kit. So an intermediate kit will be for that. Maybe it's a first homeowner that's actually into a bigger house and they need to start building out their kit. That is what the intermediate's gonna be for, is somebody that's getting into DIY and is looking at ramping up their collection a lot more. They've upgraded to a tool cart or a tool chest and they have places to store their tools. This is kind of like a closet kit. This is something where you shove in the closet in your apartment and you know you get it out when you need it. Maybe keep it underneath the cabinet, underneath the sink, and wham bam, you've got it. It's right there when you need it. So I'll give you guys a little teaser. All right guys, a little teaser for the intermediate video. We've got a propane map gas torch, infrared thermometer, and a pipe wrench. So stay tuned for the intermediate kit and things that you might need when you're getting more advanced and getting better at your DIY. So guys, I'm gonna roll in the price list of everything we have here on the table. for the beginner's toolkit. I think this is a great start for anybody that needs a just a basic bare bones toolkit to get them by. As always, you will be expanding to more things. You'll be getting a tool chest in the future. Maybe, you know, you get a garage and now you need more tools. You want to start working on things. As you learn and as you grow, you will be adding on to this toolkit. So consider this a bare bones beginner, the first toolkit you ever own, and it should be a good one. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I would love to see you click subscribe. I hope you find value in my content. Give me a thumbs up or thumbs down, whatever you're into. Ring that bell because I'm coming out with videos every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday at noon. If you're one of my subscribers already and you've already rang that bell, we'll see you guys in the next video.